And we're here, we have it, the Aino 3D RTX 3060 Ti from Aino 3D, of course, TwinX 2OC. So let's check this out and see the content. Of course, this is a brand new box. Unbox. And then let's see what's inside. I'll make this a very quick one so we can run some tests after this. This is the unboxing, and then we'll check the performance after this. Okay, we have a shiny anti-static back. So this is the TwinX 2OC from Aino 3D RTX 3060 Ti. It's kind of heavy actually, judging from the weight. It's okay, let's see. The first look, it's very symmetrical. Okay, on both sides you have two fans with, oh, there's a lot of blades. Okay, the fan, I can say it's not really wobbly. Okay, quality is, I would say 7/10, 8/10, roughly that area. And at this side we can see the 8-pin PCIe power is roughly at the 55 to 60% distance from the head to the end. Okay, and all these parts here are the heat sink. Okay, so the back fan is actually blowing all the hot cold air into the heat sink, and hot air will be exhausted over this area here. And the graphics card PCB is actually only half of the whole graphics card. So the heatsink here is actually really, really huge. It's 2 times the length of the PCB. And here we can see 2 connectors. So I would assume it's either for the fan or maybe for the RGB. Okay, from here, as usual, our connectors. We can see from here, from the top down view, I'm not sure whether it's very obvious or not. Okay, we can actually see from the side. Okay, we have a slight hint over here. It's actually four heat pipes. That's 4 heat pipes running through here. Yes, you can actually see it from this side. 1, 2, 3, 4. There's actually 4 heat pipes running through this card. So let's plug it into our PC and see how it goes. Okay, I have our Aino 3D installed on the system. We'll be doing an open air test on the 3060 Ti TwinX OC by Aino 3D. So you have a white logo over here, and for the 8-pin power, so it's a bit dark over here. And for the power pin, instead of connecting the usual, okay, the usual which we connect this way, this will be the other direction. Okay, the clip will be at the middle part instead of the upper part. And we'll turn back to our screen and let's wait for it to boot, the first boot, and we'll check out the temperature. So we have booted it up and currently it's hovering at 1680 MHz on the Core clock and 7000 MHz on our memory clock. So this is 35 Celsius on idle. And before we run our 3D Mark Port Royal test, I'll go for a 5-minute test drive on the firmware and we'll see the temperature. Okay, currently it's 35 and let's go for a stress test. Let's go. I'll come back in 5 minutes and we'll check out the temperature. Right now, we are 7 minutes into the burn test. And the card is only running at 67 Celsius. It's very stable, it doesn't really fluctuate. So let's proceed with our Port Royal test. Of course, I'll have to close this first. We are running an Intel i5-9600K clocked at 4.9 GHz with 32 gigs of 3006 MHz RAM. So hopefully I won't bottleneck this too much, although I think I'll be bottlenecking partially. And without further ado, let's go and do a run on our Port Royal. So once we are done, I'll come back and show you guys the result that we get. And we are back. We finished our Port Royal test and we got 6943 on the score for the 3060 Ti. And on Battlefield 5, we can be estimating around 105 FPS on 1440p Ultra. So on 1080p, you get like crazy amount of FPS. And Apex Legend, this is just an estimation, okay? Most likely due to my bottlenecking processor over here. I'm sorry about that. And Fortnite, of course, Red Dead Redemption, a bit low, but it's all right. But what we can see here is our score on our Port Royal. So after running, and we are back to idle at 44 Celsius with maximum roughly around 60 plus Celsius. And this is once again the Ino 3D iChill. No, it's not the iChill. This is Ino 3D RTX 3060 Ti Twin X2 OC. So I'll see you guys on the next video.